بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم السلام عليكم and welcome to another episode of Ramadan Reflections. And today we will be talking about an aspect of the human being which differentiates us from the rest of creation, and that is the tongue and the ability to speak and articulate ourselves and communicate, and how we can ensure that we use our tongue for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and protect ourselves from the harms of our tongues. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us from the most noblest of His creation, and that is the human being. And when we look at the human being, we see some of the most amazing and wondrous aspects of the creation of human beings, from the eye to the brain, to the muscle structures that we have, to the cardiovascular system that we are blessed with. So many wonders Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed within human beings that scientists even till today continue to discover new and amazing facts about the human being. From amongst the unique qualities of a human being is the ability to articulate. And in Arabic, the human being is called al-haywanun natiq, the speaking or articulating being or animal. And so this tongue is a blessing, but just like every blessing, how we use it determines whether we are rewarded for it or whether we take ourselves down the path of the displeasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we look at the tongue, it has the ability to bring immense benefit, but it also has the ability to bring immense harm. And the scholars of self-purification tell us that the tongue is that part of the body that can potentially commit more sins than any other part of the body. When we look at the sins that we can commit with the different parts of our body, they're limited to a few things. But the list of things that we can do with our tongue is quite lengthy. And the Prophet ﷺ tells us in a hadith that a true believer is the one that others are saved from their hands and their tongue. In other words, a description of a believer and a true Muslim is that they do not say things which are unbefitting and which are harmful to others. Words can be carried by modern day technology and can be passed around the world in moments, and it can stir up animosity and hatred. It can entice people to commit sins. So the tongue is something that we should guard at all times. And the Prophet ﷺ tells us in a hadith narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim that an individual may say a word that he or she considers insignificant, but it can be a cause of them entering the hellfire by the distance of that which is between the east and the west. And so the gravity, the weight of a word and what we say is very heavy on the scales on the Day of Judgment. And when we look at the likes of Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the one who was known for the truthfulness of his speech, that he would carry stones in his mouth in order to prevent himself from saying something without paying consideration to it. And so this is something that we really need to focus on. We see a hadith in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal where he talks about two women who were fasting in the month of Ramadan, and they were close to passing out from the length of the fast. And they sent a message to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam that asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam for permission that we can break our fast. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam told the individual, the messenger, for them to go and take out into the vessel that he sent whatever they had consumed. And what came out was flesh and blood and these kinds of things. And what the Prophet ﷺ said is these people were fasting from that which Allah allowed them to break their fast with. In other words, their state, because they were in a state of difficulty, they could have broken their fast. There would have been no sin in them. But what they engaged in instead was backbiting. And that is likened in Islam to eating the flesh of your dead brother. And so we need to be very careful about how we use our tongue and always reflect that these words that we are sending forth will be on our scales on the Day of Judgment. Do we want them to be on our right side or on our left side? And they are scribes writing down what we are saying. So let's ensure that when we say something, that it's of benefit. And that is the golden rule. The Prophet ﷺ said that, advised us that when we speak, we should speak good or we should remain silent. And the best way to keep our tongues engaged in good is to stay in a state of dhikr. Always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say alhamdulillah, say subhanallah, say Allahu Akbar, say la ilaha illallah, say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Say these things as a default state of your tongue, and then the only thing that should stop you from being in a state of dhikr is something beneficial that you need to say to another human being. Otherwise, it's not worth it. Otherwise, you are greater than saying something that is not befitting to your nobility as a follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, the messenger who was praised for the use of his tongue. He was known as As-Sadiq Al-Ameen. He was known as the truthful one and the trustworthy one. And the reason why people followed him initially was because of the truthfulness of his tongue and the purity of his tongue. So let's, inshallah, we make dua during this month of Ramadan that we purify our tongues and we ensure that only that which is beneficial comes forth from it. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his guidance and his support. Ameen ya rabbal alameen wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Jazakumullah khair for watching another episode of Ramadan Reflections. Please pass on this message to others and share in the reward.